first of all, operating is there, I don't think there's any question that operating is the far and away the most wonderful job, acting aside, the most wonderful job in the movies, because it combines aesthetics and athletics and everything at the same time, you know? I mean, you have to be very good and you have to make choices at 24 frames a second at the same time and always put her head there and his shoulder here and make that, you know, make that composition work. And you have to be able to do it like that at the same time. And it's, if you're good at it, it's incredibly satisfying and exciting and sexy, and you don't have to talk to the director and everything all the time, and you can flirt with the girls, and it's just wonderful, wonderful job. And I often, and I will say, I really was very good at it. I'd always been athletic, and I'd always been interested in art and thus composition and framing and those things, and the two just went together in my hands and my head, and I just, oh, I loved it. And as I think I said earlier, I worked for Gordon Willis for about, I can't remember, 6, 7 years, whatever it was, all of his early movies, Godfather, Clute, all the rest. And so we really, and Gordy took this stuff extremely seriously, and we talked endlessly and drew diagrams and argued and drank too much and drew more diagrams and talked more for month after month and year after year about exactly that, about framing and how it should go and how it should look. And we worked out a system together, or we worked out a kind of aesthetic of it together that we were very happy with. And so every day I would get up and frame pictures. I mean, what more could anyone ask? It was heavenly. And yes, it very much influenced my work as a DP, because on the simplest level, I whenever I could, I operated my own movies. And we would pay somebody and he would, you know, maybe do the B camera, or he would just go away and let me do it. And that's the most satisfying, and I think the best way to go, if you possibly can. Obviously, you can't sometimes when you've got a big explosion or something where there are 17 cameras and you've got a special effects and you've got to watch. But if they're just in the normal course of things, you shoot the master and the over-the-shoulder and the two-shot and this and that, it's wonderful to be able to do it yourself, because you can see, once you're used to it, you can see the little nuances of light, how it changes when he turns his head to her, and when she, you know, looks like that at him, and you can see whether it really works. And also you can, when you operate for yourself, you can take chances that you couldn't take as an operator for someone else, no matter how much you and he loved and respected each other, as Gordy and I did. But when I would operate for myself, I could take real chances, because who was going to yell at me, you know? If I made a mistake, if I screwed up, I could yell at myself, and so I would do really outrageous things and get away with them. I mean, I would not worry about whether the frame was on the top of her head or whether it would cut off here or there, and I would really go for what felt, just intuitively felt wonderful. Plus, I got to do lots of handheld stuff, which I loved. Handheld is one of the most, it's the closest sort of to acting and dancing and being with them that there is. And like, it, for instance, Jaws is, once they got on the ocean, almost entirely handheld. And wonderful, because it was such fun to do. Such great fun to do. And in those days, they didn't have any monitors or anything. And so I was the only person that could tell Steven what was going on, because I was the only person who could see it. So they had to do what I said. It was wonderful. I mean, they had to, you know what I mean? I don't mean do what I said, but they had to listen to me and be guided by what I could see, because we were out in the middle of the ocean and bouncing up and down, and I was having the camera on my shoulder. Operating is heavenly, heavenly job.